Hi everyone! In this video we're going to explore how to connect your Dark Project keyboard to our software. A small disclaimer before we continue. If you own the latest Terra Nova or Terra Nostra flagships, you will not find this video useful because your keyboard uses Vial. You can find more information about that by following the link in the description. If you got your keyboard before 2022, then you will not find this video helpful. All lineups before 2022 have archived offline software, which you can download from the old website. You can find the link to the old download center in the description. Now we can move on to the software guide. You will need two things to access our web-based software. 1. A Chromium-based browser of your choice. It can be Google Chrome, Brave, Opera, Microsoft Edge, or the built-in Xbox browser. 2. Your Dark Project keyboard. Once you've made sure you have the right browser, simply go to the following website, software.darkproject.eu. Once you're here, simply click Select Device, then choose your keyboard on the pop-up window and click Connect. Once the software loads, we can see two things. The list of connected devices that are supported by our software and the firmware update. Let's first update our firmware. And now that our keyboard is up to date, we can click on it to access the control panel. This is where you can customize everything on your keyboard. Let's begin with RGB by clicking the sun icon. Here you have an arrangement of different modes to choose from. You can control the brightness, the speed, and the direction of the effect by adjusting these bars right here. If you're like me and you don't want your keyboard to look like a disco ball, you can pick a solid color instead. You can scroll down to Custom, select all keys, pick your color, and save your preset. From here, we will move on to Snap Tap, which is the second most asked question we get. You can activate Snap Tap by flicking this lever or by holding down Function and Right Shift on your keyboard. Additionally, you can adjust the priority of the keys here, and you can create a new group of keys by clicking this button. Please don't forget to save your configuration. Next, we will create a quick macro. All that is needed is to hit the record button, type what we want, stop recording, and hit save. Lastly, we can move to key assignment, where we can manage every keystroke and macro. Keep in mind that you can customize the function of every single key, except the function key, because it's tied to factory presets. Let's change the function of page down, which I never use. For the pause key, I will add the combination Alt plus F4 for when I want to rage quit Minecraft. And for the page up button, I will turn it into a macro key by going to the gear icon and clicking save. The debounce time won't make your keyboard as fast as you think, but feel free to tweak with it if you want. Just keep in mind that when you go under 5 milliseconds, there's a chance of double clicking. And that's all. I hope you've enjoyed this guide. If you did, please smash the like button and leave a comment down below if you have any more questions. Thank you for watching.